Professor McGonagall tried to warn you, Zasha. But I was frozen by Professor McGonagall's stem star. That's enough, Mr. Cannon. Angelica returned the answer to Durance while I'm tampering with the Gryffindor common room. When she noticed Mr. Cannon's suspicious behavior, she did the right thing and found her head of hope. Then we find you leaving our common room, a place you know you are forbidden to enter. Explain your behavior, Mr. Ernst. I only did it because I was trying to find my friend, Ben Cooper. He's a Gryffindor too. I'm aware. Why you think sneaking into our common room won't help find him? It sounds stupid, but I was hoping he was hiding somewhere inside. I have to check everywhere. I'm afraid he might be hurt. I assume you didn't find him? No. Very well. Be on your way. You aren't going to take host points from him? I draw Mr. Ernst made an ill-advised decision. He showed great courage and did so in search of his friend. His girlfriend of friend. And I know he will never attempt to enter another house's common room ever again. Hey, Sasha. Are you feeling any effects from using the shrinking and enlargement charms on yourself? I feel fine. Though I do have a newfound respect for insects. What do you think the secret instructions will say? I hope Ben wasn't being forced to do something terrible. The only way to find out is to untransfigure this black quill. Repairing fair. Thank you. across it to the farthest corridor at the east end of the fifth floor. Transfigure the scroll back into a black hill and return it to the Gryffindor common room. Failure to follow your instructions will result in severe punishment. Severe punishment? Is that what happens to Ben? What's in the corridor? Nothing that I know of. No one ever goes there. Why was he supposed to put the quill back where he found it? Maybe he isn't the only one receiving these instructions. I have a bad feeling about this, Sasha. Dumbledore said, if you find anything odd, we shall tell our professor. Do you really think we should explore the corridor? Penny is worried about Ben too. I will ask her to explore the corridor with me while you tell Dumbledore. Or you're gonna go. Okay, just be careful, Sasha. You don't need to speak to me, Ernst, ever. How many house points have you earned us this year? I still think it's a mistake you were put in, Slytherin. Have you heard, Sasha? Slytherin is planning on making the Gryffindors shut their mouth about their Quidditch victory. What's the plan? Our prophet is about to share it with everyone in the Slytherin common room. Due to failure and incompetence by some of you, Gryffindor stumbled their way into eating us in Quidditch. They won't shut their mouths about it, though we are going to shut their mouth for that. Worst of all, they cost us horse points. We have allowed their braggadocious officials to persist for far too long. Braggadocious wolves. All we need is a plan to put them in their place. A plan for revenge. Are you a writer, Rowan? You're just repeating what I say in a slightly different way. He will be fine. Rowan just wants to ensure that Slytherin always reminds the Topos. I love seeing so many Slytherins gathered in one place. It's a cunning plan, but we have to decide who will take the lead. It needs to be someone who is powerful and ambitious enough to never stop until we have our revenge against Gryffindor. Who shall be chosen? I'd be honored to lead us against Gryffindor and shut their mouths once and for all. You are as ambitious and cunning as they come, Sasha. I'm proud to have you in this house. Let's show Gryffindor that they will never truly win against Slytherin. I'm so cold. Obviously. There's Ben. Hide. Right.